Okay, we good. We good. We good. I think we good. Am I good? I look good. Okay. Dang, y'all always be doing this every time I start a video. Okay, let's get it popping. Okay. What you call an icon living? Thought we could live a mission, just did it. Nah, I love people by Dennis. Whoa, we up to my independence. Must have make a movie independent. What's up, y'all? It's your boy RJ Powell. We are back with another video today, and today we're gonna be reacting to another NBA all-time list. It's not by B-Souls again. Well, it kind of is, but it's kind of not. We're gonna be reacting to Flight Reacts top 10 NBA players of all time. Flight might be the biggest troller on YouTube right now because I don't know if he's being trolling or if he's being dead serious. We're gonna be reacting to his top 10 NBA players of all time. Now the video is by B-Souls. We're gonna take a look at this, y'all. So let's not waste any more time. Let's get it popping. Like, wow.
What it do, Flight Truth? FTC? Flight Team?
Sit down.
Flight reacted to my top 50 all-time video.
We did,
and,
too.
Let's just say he didn't really like
it. We didn't like it either.
Top 50.
I'm not going to lie. I agree with Flight right here. I didn't really like the list. I didn't really like the list.
Being real, bro.
Now, a lot of people wanted me to clap back a Flight because apparently Flight said I didn't know anything about basketball.
I mean, a lot of people didn't like the list, bro. A lot of people didn't like the list.
That little smirk I just did is the most clapback y'all are gonna get from me. But I
wow.
think it'd actually be more interesting to actually try to construct Flight React's top 10 players of all time.
This is gonna be interesting.
The reaction video he posted.
I'm excited for this.
There was actually a lot of clues that he threw throughout the whole video that I believe I can make at least a draft of what his top 10 all time should
be. Okay, so this is like a prediction of what his top 10 could be like. But I'm guessing he's probably gonna have Steph Curry at number one, Allen Iverson in top three probably.
Now, as far as the format of this video, I'm going to go ahead and show y'all at what part of Flight's video he actually gave us clues regarding his top 10 all time.
Okay.
And then I'm going to show y'all all the clues I gathered at the end of the video, construct the top 10.
So we're playing the guessing game right here. Okay.
And then I'm going to
go over some. Cool.
Number 40, we have Willis Reed, 39, John Stockton, 38, Allen Iverson, 36.
Whoa! Whoa! Hey! No! Oh, whoa, whoa! No, you're up already, bro.
Dang.
What the
he's a big Allen
Iverson
fan, though,
this
so.
High already, bro. This means that you have some towards the end. Iverson needs to be in the top 10, bro.
What?
I don't know about top 10.
My opinion, he's top 5. If you don't want to put him top 5, you have to put him in the top 10. But
I don't know about top 10 Flight, but he's great. He's great.
He exploded at the sight of seeing Allen Iverson at 38 on my list.
Because but I don't think top
Flight,
10. No.
Allen Iverson should at least be top 10. On his personal list, he's top 5. Now, he never really mentioned in the video.
I mean,
there's
nothing wrong with
the
that. Your favorite
sounded,
player,
I think
Allen
Flight
Iverson.
Believes
no.
that, you know, it's kind of just a given fact and that it's a no brainer that he should be at least above players like Kevin Garnett and Charles Barkley and players of that caliber. And that obviously he should be top 10. Now, I don't want to really get into why I ranked Allen Iverson at 38. I'm really just trying to see where Flight's head is at when it comes to his all time rankings.
Okay.
And based on what he just said, according to him, Allen Iverson is in his top 5. He didn't really have any problems up until the top 20 because this is where I revealed that Wilt was 13 on my list. Which, to be fair, he's not the only person who's had a problem with me doing that. And according to Flight, it was...
Will Chamberlain should not be number 13 on an all-time list. He should be top 10.
At the very least, be in the top
5. He should be top 10 at least.
Will
Chamberlain should be top 10.
Say,
you put Wilt the Stilt Chamberlain, the person that has the most points ever scored in NBA history, at number 13 on your f***ing list. This is the most selfish I have ever seen anybody do, bro.
I didn't like the list neither. I'm with you, Flight. I didn't like the list neither.
Wilt Chamberlain is in the top 5, bro. Like, he's in the top 5.
I don't know
time.
About top 5, but
he has
definitely, I think he's definitely top 10. I think he's definitely top 10.
Kevin Durant is kind of, you know, kind of shaky, you know, but he, in my opinion, he's like top 15. You could place him anywhere. I personally would put Kevin Durant somewhere around 7 or 6. Steph Curry needs to be another person in the top 5. He changed the game. This is really disrespectful to put
Steph
a player
Curry is
of
not
this
top
caliber
right now.
In a top,
he's not top
in the 11th
right
spot.
Like, come on now. Let's be real
this
here.
This is selfish, bro. Curry is misplaced. He needs to be in the top 5. He needs to be in, like, number 2.
Stop, Flight. Stop. That's where I'm not with you right there. I'm not with you right there. He's not top 2 of all time.
This was the one I was
not
top
two
well, because we know
I'm
Flight
sorry,
and Curry
Flight,
have that, you know, they got that special connection in the NBA community.
Look at Curry, man.
Yeah, look at Curry, man. Just trying to do great things in the world. This is dope, you know yo.
Five more times.
Curry, man. Just trying to...
And I just find it so funny that besides Flight, everyone that had something to say about my Curry and KD placement said that if anything, I put them too high, but only Flight would think that Curry being placed at 11 is too low. But hey, again, that's his opinion. I just found that funny.
Yeah, it's his opinion, but
he flat out says that Curry should be number two all time.
Yeah.
So that's another clue on our
No sir. Oh my gosh, bro.
Number 3, Magic Johnson.
What?
Number 2, LeBron James.
What?
And number 1, Michael Jeffrey.
Oh my gosh, bro. This dude has no knowledge whatsoever, bro.
Wait. Stop the motherfucking music. You. Are you dumb?
He's the one to talk, though.
You didn't put Iverson anywhere in the top 10. You put Tim Duncan, Larry Bird. You put those two in front of Iverson, bro. Tim Duncan needs to be where Iverson is at. It's 38, bro.
Huh?
Tim Duncan needs to be where Iverson is at. It's 38, bro.
Nah.
You put Larry Bird and Tim Duncan in front of Iverson.
No. We're not doing that here. No TD's land over here.
Tim Duncan should be in the 30s. Meaning at the very least, he does not believe he's top 10. And with the way he talked about Bird as well in that same sentence, I would say he believes that same thing as well.
He said Larry Bird, like, 30s? What?
Bill Russell and Kareem Abdul-Jabbar in front of Wilt Chamberlain, let alone Shaq. Bro, Shaq would body out of Bill Russell, bro. Bro, are you sick? Bro, Magic Johnson, bro? First of all, Magic Johnson didn't even finish his career, bro. He had to retire early. Magic Johnson needs to be where Harden is at or Isaiah Thomas at. Let's be 1,000%.
Yo, Flight, you're almost giving me a headache. He's giving me a headache right now. Like, what?
And he also says that he's not really too against LeBron being top 5. And to close it off, I know he already said it earlier, but once again, he does not have a problem with Michael Jordan being
I don't think anybody really has a problem with MJ being on his list.
That's about it in terms of all the clues he gave in the video about his personal top 10. So let's go ahead and go over them real quick.
Okay.
So number 1, we got that Allen Iverson is in his top 10.
We also got that Will
Chamberlain is also in his top 10. He has Kevin Durant at around 6 or 7.
Okay.
He has Stephen Curry.
Steph Curry has to be in that top 10.
On his list, Tim Duncan is not top 10, and it's probably in the 30s. And he made a similar comment about Larry Bird. He also believes that Bill Russell and Kareem are not above Wilt and Shaq.
Okay.
He also said that he has Magic Johnson in the 20s.
That's absurd. He's
not top 10.
Absurd.
He said LeBron is fine in the top 5 and that Michael Jordan is one on his list.
Okay, so we already know MJ is one, Steph Curry is two.
Let's go ahead and build the actual list. So 1 and 2 are
that's a definitely Curry definitively. Definitely
he said that multiple times.
Even though Steph Curry had 2 is not it.
The clues that he gave that Will Chamberlain and Allen Iverson should be top 5. I would assume that the rest of his top 5 consists of LeBron, Wilt, and Allen Iverson.
Yeah, that would probably be Flight's top 5
on his list because he did seem to value influence on the game a lot based on his
reactions. Yeah, he really values influence over anything.
Towards those early 2000s
which
players.
Kind of fine,
want to clarify that nowhere in this video did he give a specific order in this part of the list. Just know that 1 and 2 are MJ and Curry, and 3, 4, and 5 is some combination of Allen Iverson, Will Chamberlain,
and LeBron.
That's for sure. Now, 6 through 10 is where I had to make the most assumptions.
Yeah, this is going to be difficult.
The only thing he directly mentioned in the video when it comes to this part of the list is KD being 6 or 7. So I decided to put him at 7.
Okay.
The players he specifically said did not belong in the top 10 were Larry Bird, Tim Duncan, and Magic Johnson.
Yeah.
And I honestly probably say Bill Russell as well. Though he never explicitly said it, talk highly of him in the video.
Yeah.
Now, for the rest of the players, he didn't really have anything to say about Kobe. He also just said Kareem shouldn't be above Wilt and Shaq, and he didn't really say anything about Hakeem. But I would assume that he believes Shaq is at least better than Hakeem based on his reaction. Now, this is going to sound a little confusing, but in terms of where I think he thinks they rank, I'd say that he has Kobe at 6, KD at 7, Shaq at 8, Hakeem at 9, and Kareem at 10.
But does Flight really know Hakeem?
Kobe at 6 is because
are we just gonna assume? Wait. Are we just gonna assume that Flight really knows Hakeem, the Dream Olajuwon?
Domantas Sabonis.
Seriously, I'm not questioning if Flight really knows him, but does he actually know Hakeem?
Hell no!
Maybe he does have Shaq at 6 and Kobe at 8. All I'm assuming is that 6 through 8 is some combination of KD, Kobe, and Shaq. And 9 and 10 specifically is where I had the most trouble looking clues for because he never really mentioned anything about that part of the list. So I just put Akeem and Kareem there because, again, he didn't really have anything to say about them. So I'd assume that he didn't really have any problems with them being in the top 10. But me personally, I do have this gut feeling that he does have a soft spot for D-Wade, and he might put him there as well. So there you have it, a rough draft
of Flight's top 10 players of all time.
At least based on the statements he made from his reaction to my list. Flight, if you end up watching this, let me know if I messed up somewhere or if I misplaced anyone or if I twisted your words a little bit.
Let's be honest here. If you're detailing your favorite NBA players of all time, this wouldn't be a bad list. But if you're saying, like, of all time, of course it's flawed. Of course Steph Curry at 2, AI at 3 is not ideal. I wouldn't even have KD in my top 10 right now, but...
I don't know, it's giving me a headache as well. I'm actually curious to see what your reaction is if you do end up reacting to this video. But aside from that, I do want to mention a couple of takes that Flight also said in the video that didn't pertain to his top 10.
Okay,
probably the first one he made in the video period about rankings was that he said that Dwight Howard should not be top 100, let alone top 50, and that if anything
not top 100, that's a stress, bro. Dwight Howard
should not be in a top 50 all-time list. Like, I'm not trying to like just be in, like, he shouldn't be on a list, you know what I'm saying? Like, he shouldn't know. Like, he shouldn't even be on a top 100, to be honest with you.
Okay, stop, Flight. Stop.
Maybe
stop.
Like top 400.
He also said that Clyde Drexler shouldn't be in the top 50 because all he did was dunk when the man was averaging 27, 6, and 8 in his prime on good defense.
Exactly. What, Flight?
Okay.
To be honest, Clyde Drexler was a good player. All he could do was dunk, though. He shouldn't even be on this list, to be honest with you. He should be in the top 100, not top 50.
And he said that Chris Paul, even though he's in his top 20 favorite players of all time, shouldn't be top 50, and that if I have him in the top 50, that I should also have players like Baron Davis, Stephon Marbury, Damian Lillard, and Kyrie Irving in there.
I don't know who this man is. I mean, he could be walking down the street. I wouldn't know a thing.
CP3 shouldn't even be on this. He needs to be in the top 100, not top 50, bro. No. You know what I'm saying? Like, how do you not put people like Baron? If you put CP3 here, you might as well put Baron Davis here.
Yep. We might be done. Hold up. We gotta
be here, not Baron Davis.
What?
You know what I'm saying? Or Stephon Marbury or somebody more like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
what?
Or Kyrie Irving, you know? Damian Lillard, at least. I'll put Damian Lillard in front of Chris Paul.
Okay. That's going to do it for the video. Leave a like, comment, subscribe. Subscribe to the Power Family for more basketball, NBA, all sorts of content every single day. Or I try to get it every single day. We're coming with more quality content. So be on the lookout for that. Flight Reacts, top 10 NBA players of all time. Oh my gosh, that gave me a headache. And his takes at the end, I couldn't take it no more. So we're just going to leave it as that. Again, hope y'all doing safe during quarantine. And hopefully y'all don't have the same takes at Flight React. Hope he's not being this dead serious because if he is, oh my gosh. Anyways, y'all, dream it, believe it, live it. Mama mentality forever. I'm just going to go on that note right there. Oh my gosh. Flight, what are you thinking? CP3, you put Step Marbury in top 50. Damian. Oh, ah.
Okay. How we doing?